Good morning, children. This is Ved Gopal sir for Little Hearts Publications with English Book 4, Lesson 4, The Clever Brothers. What do you mean by clever? Clever means being intelligent, wise. To be able to understand and analyze things in a perfect manner is generally called clever. Now, do you have that intelligence? Do you call yourself a clever boy or girl, or a foolish boy or girl? What is meant by being clever? Being clever is nothing but being intelligent, being wise, being able to analyze things in a perfect manner. So, the children who are good at studies and who are good at judgment, or who are good at analyzing things properly and perfectly, are generally called clever children. In this story, we are going to talk about the clever brothers. In what way they are clever and why they are called clever brothers, let us see an interesting story. The king's court was full of people who had assembled to witness the trial that was to take place that day. It was a king's court, a king's darbar. It was full of people. Why they had assembled there? To witness the trial that was to take place that day. There was a trial going to take place that day in the king's court. Trial means what? A judicial examination of issues or a judicial examination of evidence is called trial. Judicial examination of evidence, that is called trial. There was a trial. Some people were charged with a crime and the king was going to decide what exactly had happened. Four young men were brought to the court. Who were brought to the court? Four young men. A traveler with his wife had also been brought before the king. Along with these four young men, a traveler means a person who travels, with his wife were also brought before the king. So, the king asked now, why were you chasing these travelers, young men? The king asked. So, we can understand from this sentence that the traveler and his wife had lodged a complaint with the king that the four young men were chasing them. Chasing means what? Running after them with a bad intention or evil intention, with an evil thought. Like that, the traveler filed a complaint in the king's court. So, the four young men were brought to the king's court along with this traveler and his wife. So, the king asked, young men, why were you chasing these travelers? O king, please excuse us. And the four young men replied like this, O king, please excuse us. Excuse means what? Forgive. Pardon. Another meaning is pardon. Sir, excuse us. Sorry, we were not following them with any bad intention. And the four brothers were saying now, replying to the king's question, Sir, we were not following, O Majesty, we were not following the young traveler with a bad intention. When we saw the footprints of a camel on our way, we thought we could make guesses about the travelers. When we were going along, we saw the footprints of a camel, which was walking there, and the footprints of a camel were found, and we thought we could make some guesses about the travelers. And we thought we could make some guesses. Guess means what? Not based on truth. Only guessing, expecting. We thought we could make some guesses about the travelers. One of my brothers said the prints were of a female camel. See, one of the brothers said, even without looking at the camel, he concluded that the footprints were of a female camel. Another brother said, her left eye was blind. This other brother said, the camel's left eye was blind. The other one said, one of the riders was a woman, and I said she must be pregnant. The other brother, the third one said, one of the riders, means the one of the persons who was riding on the back of the camel was a woman. Not only that woman was pregnant. We wanted to find out whether our guesses were right, and so we followed the travelers. The eldest of the four young men said, we wanted to find out whether our guesses were right. So just we had made some guesses, O Majesty, O King, and we wanted to find out whether our guesses were correct. And so we followed the travelers. The eldest of the four brothers gave this reply to the king's question. The king turned to the traveler and asked him whether his camel was a female. The king was very much interested in this case now. Why these four travelers or four young men wanted to take guesses about the travelers who were traveling on the back of a camel? And so he turned to the traveler and asked him whether his camel was a female. The astonished traveler and his pregnant wife said that this was true. Really, the traveler was so much astonished and also his pregnant wife was also astonished, surprised, greatly surprised. Astonished means what? Greatly surprised that this was true. What was true? His camel was a female. They also admitted that she was blind in the left eye. The other brother, one of the brothers, guessed that the camel was blind in the left eye, and that was also confirmed by the traveler and his wife. The king became curious and asked the young man how they guessed that the camel was a female and that it was blind in one eye. Now the king became very curious, very excited. And he wanted to know how these brothers, these young men, could guess that the camel was a female and it was blind without actually looking at the camel. Oh, it wasn't difficult, said one of them. Your Majesty, it was not a difficult thing at all. I noticed the way the animal had passed urine and decided that it was a female camel. One of the brothers said, Your Majesty, I noticed the way the animal had passed urine. So, a male camel and a female camel pass urine different ways. The way the animal had passed urine, one of the young men decided that it was a female camel. And she had eaten the leaves and creepers only on her right side, and so I guessed her left eye must be blind, said the other man. Because that camel had eaten the leaves and creepers only on her right side, when the camel was walking, the camel had eaten only the leaves and creepers on the right side of it, and so I guessed that the left eye must be blind. Really wonderful, isn't it, children? What a great guessing power they had. And you, asked the king, looking at the other two. Now, he looked at the other two young men. And you, young man, how you guessed the remaining things? I noticed that two of the footprints where the riders had alighted were smaller than the other two and thought that they must be a woman's, said the third man. What did the third man say? Your Majesty, I observed that two of the footprints where the riders had alighted means what? Got down. After some distance, the travelers who were sitting on the back of the camel. They had alighted, means they got down the camel. And two of the footprints were smaller than the other. Generally, women have smaller footprints than the men. And so I thought they must be a woman's footprints. The third man said. The fourth man said, I noticed that those footprints were not only smaller, but also deeper. So I concluded that the woman was pregnant. Means she was carrying a baby in her womb. That is what is called meaning of pregnant. And the fourth man said like this, Your Majesty, I noticed that those footprints were not only smaller, but also deeper. So I concluded that the woman was pregnant. Deeper means what? Because she was walking there, and those footprints were deeper because of the weight of the body, because she was pregnant. The weight of the body made the footprints deeper than the other. That's how I guessed that the woman was pregnant. The king was surprised at the intelligence of the four men and asked them to stay on at the court for some days. Really, the king was surprised now at the intelligence of the four men. You understand the meaning of being clever children now? See, this is what is called being clever. Anyway, the king was surprised at the intelligence of the four men and asked them to stay on at the court for some more days. And he asked the four young men, My dear young men, you stay here in the court for some days, some more days. I wanted to test really your intelligence. The king wanted to test them. He asked them whether there was any art in which each of them excelled. And he asked the young men there, Tell me, my dear young men, whether you are very good at or where you are excellent in any art. Each of you means who has got that excellence, particular excellence in any art. The eldest brother said, Sir, no one can remove me from my place and insult me wherever I sit in court. I can always choose my place with great care in any assembly. What does the eldest brother say to the king's question? Sir, O king, no one can remove me from my place and insult me wherever I sit in the court. Wherever in the court I am sitting, no one can remove me from my place and no one can insult me also by removing me from my place because I can always choose my place with great care in any assembly. Any court or any assembly where a lot number of people are there, I can choose my place in such a clever fashion that no one will be able to remove me or no one can make me move away from my place. That is where I excel. I am superior to anybody. I can choose my place in any assembly with such a precision, such an accuracy that nobody can make me move from my place. See, the second brother said, O king, I can judge the quality of the food very precisely. No one can excel me in it. And the second brother said, O king, I can judge the quality of the food very precisely. Precisely means accurately. Exactly. O king, I am very good at judging the quality of food. Nobody can excel me in it. Nobody can be superior to me in judging the quality of food, the second brother said. The third one said that he was an expert in distinguishing the quality of any bed or pillow. Distinguish means differentiate, show the difference between. The third brother said that he was an expert, a very excellent judge or having a special skill in distinguishing means separating or differentiating the quality of any bed or pillow. The fourth one said that he could unite parted couples however quarrelsome they might be. The fourth one said very proudly that he could unite parted couples. Parted means separated. Couples means pairs. If any husband and wife quarrel with each other, however quarrelsome that husband and wife might be, he could unite them without much effort. He could unite them means he could join them again. He could make them united again, even though they were quarrelsome. Like that, the four brothers had explained to the king the things they are excellent at. One day, the king saw the brothers sitting with a few courtiers on a carpet and chatting. The king now started testing the young men. One day, what did he see? He saw the brothers sitting with a few courtiers on a carpet and chatting. There, some courtiers were sitting there around the four brothers and they were chatting. On a carpet, they were sitting. The king immediately ordered his men to remove the carpet. The king thought, because the eldest brother said that nobody can make him move from the place where he is sitting. Means he chooses the place that he sits in any assembly in such a great precision or accuracy that nobody can remove him, can make him move from the place. So the king saw the four young men sitting there with some courtiers and chatting. Chatting means talking to each other. He immediately ordered the servants to remove the carpet. All those who were sitting on the carpet had to get up and move when it was rolled up and removed. All those who were sitting there on the carpet had to get up. Why? Because the carpet had to be rolled before it was removed. So, all those who were sitting on the carpet had to get up and move when it was rolled up and removed. The king thought that the oldest of the four men who was sitting on the carpet would also have to get up. The king thought that the eldest of all the four brothers, who had said that nobody could move him from the place where he was sitting in any assembly, he also would have to get up. Like that, the king thought. But the eldest brother had chosen the place on the edge of the carpet, and so he was able to push the carpet away without getting up. And where exactly this eldest brother was sitting, he had chosen his place in such a way at the edge of the carpet. So without getting up, he was able to push the carpet. He just moved a little, not got up. He just pushed the carpet away from under him. Like that, without getting up from the place, he sat there, but the carpet was removed. The carpet was rolled up while he was sitting where he was without being disturbed in the least. So the carpet was rolled up even while he was sitting there where he was. Why? Because he pushed the carpet away from him, from under him, and without being disturbed. He was not disturbed in any way. So the eldest brother proved how clever he was in choosing his place in any assembly. Days passed, some days passed like that. One evening after dinner was over, the second brother came to the king and said, some days after what happened, one evening the dinner was finished, the second brother came to the king and said, "Oh king, pardon me," means forgive me, "did you notice that the rice served for lunch smelled of cow's urine? Oh majesty, kindly forgive me for saying this to you. Did you notice that in the afternoon the lunch was served, the rice served to us smelled of cow's urine? Did you notice that one?" The king became angry and sent for the chief cook. The king became angry, immediately sent for the chief cook. The chief cook came running. And the chief cook, who was the main cook there in the king's court, he came running there. "This gentleman says that this rice served today smelt of cow's urine. Is this true?" The king asked him angrily, that cook. "Hey, Mr. Cook, this gentleman says that," means he was pointing to the second brother, "that the rice served today smelt of cow's urine. Is this true?" You remember, children, the second brother said that he was a very good judge in judging the quality of food. So, that particular afternoon, rice was served for lunch, and he noticed that the rice smelt of cow's urine. The same thing he conveyed to the king. The king sent for the chief cook, and when he came there, the king asked him whether the food that particular afternoon smelt of cow's urine. Okay, children, we will complete there in the, we will continue in the next class. Thank you.